Hey, Pet Buddies. Paul Roberts, RT1 here. And today we're going to do the Cowl Vault's request stance. I'm utilitarian. Everything that I'm going to talk about today is not going to probably work in your house. I used to have a house in a historic neighborhood in downtown Orlando. It was a classic. It had classic furniture, everything, you know. It had the plaster walls, the big drapes and everything. I put my Batman things in there a few times in a couple little places in the corner. Like, this doesn't work. So I've never been to where I decorate my house with my collectibles. I keep that separate. The idea of how to make these great stands and everything just don't exist. What I do is all utilitarian. So, I mean, some of these styrofoam heads I've had for 30 years. You take a 5-gallon bucket, pour some plaster in there, put a PVC pipe or a metal pipe or a wood dowel in there, hold it up with some tape on the top while it's setting, or a couple of pieces of the board to hold to make sure it stays straight. That's your simple thing. And then you see years and years and years worth of every type of latex that falls on the bottom there. I had some cowls that I wanted to use as keys or various props that I wasn't gonna get rid of. And what I did was I took my original head form. Let's get rid of this. So what I did was I took my original head form. This is what my original cowl sculpted on. And I got some mold material and I put that over there. And I used to have, and I'll probably do it again if I want any more. I used to have a plaster thing that goes over top of this. And I would have latex cure inside there and inject with foam and come up with something like this. This is foam. This is the inside of this. Most of my cowls have the support of the shoulders. Some of them have to be on a stand because the cowl goes down further than this. Basically, this is a stand that I made just for my capes while they're waiting to go out. I keep various things that I find around the neighborhood. This pole, various pipes, a little piece of wood. All this is simply to hang a cape so it doesn't get wrinkled if it's waiting to go out. That's all this is. Simple pole that I had. You know, keep various things. I keep various things. I don't go out and buy things. I do this on a very limited budget. I'll go running, or I'm driving down the street, find an old chair. The rest of the chair is no good, but this is solid, heavy wood, maybe oak. And just simply say, okay, I'm gonna put that together and I'm gonna make something out of it, okay? Like the other day, I came home and, you know, around here, I don't live in that old classic house anymore. I make things work. It's mostly furnished with things that I find. I don't go out and buy expensive furniture and things like that. There's no need in this world today, not where I live anyway. So the other day I was coming home and found this fan. I got two other fans and they work great. Use them in the house. And I thought, well, okay, I'll bring it home. You know, sometimes people put things out that work and they want people to get them. They don't want them thrown out. It didn't work. I took it apart. I thought, oh, that'd be fun. I'll take it apart and see if I can figure out how it works. No, couldn't get it to work. It was burnt out. So I took the bottom off it and I took another pipe. My friend brought me this broom over the other day. He finds things he doesn't have any use for. He says, can you use them? It's falling down piece of junk. I didn't use it in the way that he had intended, but I put it to use in another way. I took the broom handle off and I put this together with the fan thing. And here you have another stand. I don't know what I'm gonna do with this. I could use it as another cape stand if I did this. But the point is, part of the fun and part of the doing something for free is making it work with what you got. I have no overhead. I've never invested in anything I do in 30 years. I make things work. If I invest in something, it's because I've got a sale and I need the materials to make it. So that's really the way I am. Every once in a while, I have like an extra of something like this and I'll cut it up. I say, I want the head for something else, but this is still useful. Pop a thing on there, boom. It still works. I've heard people talk about you go to Home Depot, you buy a wood doll, you take a nice base, maybe at Michael's or Joann's or Hobby Lobby, that's nice and lacquered and stained and everything, and you put the doll in there and it looks nicer. Or some people want to have the thing shaped like a bat at the bottom, or maybe a bat symbol underneath it or something like that. You can do things like that. There's like no way to say, this is the way. What I do in my life is, there is no way. I make the way, you know? So that's my best advice on stands. And you're doing a good job so far, person that requested the video. Keep doing it. Think out of the box. Think about what's your life gonna look like in a year or two from now. You're gonna eventually run out of space. So what are you gonna do? You'll have to keep on rotating the stock maybe, or find a way to get more condensed. I don't know. I get rid of my things when I have no use for them. It's one of the reasons why I don't even have a suit most of the time. It is what it is. Change it. Make it new, or it'll die, right? So that's my video on stands. And thanks again for your input and support and the encouragement of things that you do in your own life and the enthusiasm. I get drawing power off of that and I appreciate it. I'm Paul Roberts, RT1, And that's the video for today. Talk to you later, bat buddies.